much as our pedestrians, that they should be in the street, that it's safer to be in the street, when really it's just dangerous for bicyclists. If you look at the statistics of how many bicyclists are killed by vehicles every year, it's astronomical. And the idea that the city of Keene has policy which says that if you are injured, you can't really walk too well, that you should be riding a bicycle in the street, for me it seems like a recipe for disaster. So that's why I feel that with this case, roads weren't made for bicyclists, and the sidewalks apparently weren't made for them either in Keene, because there's a $150 fine for just apparently sitting up on your bike and moving it with your feet. Now, to me, that was easier than putting strain and weight on my ankle that day.
You're straining into testimony now. I can't consider that.
Okay, that's fine. You can just disregard anything you consider irrelevant. As testified by Ms. McDermott and Officer Moore, that despite the fact that I had an ankle injury, there was some sort of will to compel me into the street, and I didn't want to be in the street. I wanted to be on the sidewalk. Nobody was being bothered. As Ms. McDermott testified, the person who was so upset about myself being on the bicycle, as she stated, was not anywhere near me. I posed no danger to anyone, and the idea that so much energy and resources go into punishing bicyclists, when I think bicycling is a clean, it's much cleaner than gasoline, it's much more easy and efficient transportation, and I think we should be encouraging bicycling as opposed to punishing people for getting on bicycles downtown. Thank you.
Whether Mr. Ian agrees with it or not, the city ordinance was in effect on the date that this happened. He clearly was riding the bicycle on the sidewalks in Keene. He continued to do so despite the fact that he knew it was his and was bothered by it. There are exceptions to the bicycle ordinance. People can ride bikes in places in Keene on the sidewalk, just not downtown. And there are several places that are listed in the city ordinance that I gave to the court. And there are reasons for that. The way to change it is to obviously address the folks who enact these ordinances and not to violate them. I would ask that the court find that he is guilty of violating.
Well, I guess I tend to agree with Mr. Ian that bicycling down Main Street is dangerous, especially if there's a lot of traffic, but bicycling on the sidewalk is against the law. There's an ordinance in effect. The state has proved its case beyond reasonable doubt. Whether you're pedaling or not, it's no different than someone driving a car where they're not supposed to drive the car and just leaving it, just turning the engine off and coasting. You're still not supposed to be there. So, I'm attending a guilty finding. Standard fine?
Yes,
sir. That's fine. Does this get the penalty assessment?
Yes.
This does get the penalty assessment. So the fine total is $155. Can you pay that this morning?
No.
Okay. Do you need time to pay that?
I think 60 days could be sufficient. Right now I'm unemployed, so I don't have any source of
income. All right. You need to do a time payment agreement at the window.
How about community service?
Well, it depends on where you're going to do it. There's some we've had some problem with folks coming in and they do it at unacceptable places now and then, and it's a waste of time. So where would you plan to do it?
I would ask if he can be applied. I would ask if you fill out a financial affidavit.
Well, I'm supposed to do that, but I haven't been doing that with other folks. I'm not going to start now. But how are you supporting yourself? Community service is supposed to be available for people who can't afford to pay it, so.
Well, I have low overhead expenses.
So where would your community service be?
Oh, where can they take me? Is there like a community kitchen? Or?
Well, unfortunately, they were a good possibility for it, but they're not doing it anymore.
Is there a homeless shelter or something like that?
Hundred Nights, I think. Hundred Nights?
I'm probably doing work on Hundred Nights.
So it'd be 15 hours of community service at 100 nights. Give you 30 days to get that done? Half an hour a day?
Sure. I'll let you know when that happens.
Pardon? The date of 30 days?
Yeah.
November 23rd.
Okay, so we'll be back here on the 23rd of November. You need someone to sign off on your attendance. They know how to do it there.
If I certify that it's been done, can we forego a further hearing on that?
Well, if you bring it to the window and then I'm here, I can take a look at it, I can save you that, yeah.
Okay.